Hi everyone, we are doing a cicada in late spring. We have a tree with flowers and a cicada on the tree. You're going to need your pencil, you'll need crayons, an eraser, any black marker, and your sketchbook, of course. So let's get started. First, we're going to start with a thorax. And this is also, so it's an oval. And then another oval. Like this. And then we'll draw another semi-circle from here, and I'm doing it very lightly until I'm happy with the shape that I have, and then you press harder and you erase the extra lines. And a triangle. And then antenna. And circles over here. And over here for eyes. And you can color these in. Okay, behind the head, the thorax, we have the abdomen. And it's like half of an oval, but it comes to a little bit of a point at the back, like this. All right, and then the legs are attached to the thorax. So we're going to add in legs. So a cicada has six legs and then the wings. So I'm going to first make a letter V in the middle over here where the wings meet, and then I'm going to curve my line sideways. So the wings are transparent, so it means you can see the body underneath. Okay, so that's our basic cicada. And we're going to have fun with the colors. Do you have to stick to a realistic cicada, or are you going to add different colors? Let's see. I'm going to paint the abdomen first, and I don't want to make a realistic cicada. I'm going to use reds and purples. I'm going to make mine a little bit different. So I'm going to add purple and red. And a little bit of blue. Do you see the spaces I leave between my colors? It's because I am still trying to think if I want them to bleed into one another or not. Actually, I'm going to just add water and make this blue bleed into the red just for fun. So you see how the blue runs into the red, and then I'm going to make the red run into the purple. Ooh. That looks pretty. And then above that, let's see, I'm going to add red. So do you see how the colors are blending? We also call that bleeding in art. And most of the times when we paint, we don't want the colors to blend or bleed like that, but for fun we are going to break that rule today. And I'm going to just add just water to my purple and let it run into the red. And then I'm going to take the red and let it run into the blue. And leave that to dry. And then for the thorax, let's just make a blue thorax. And you see how it's running? Because two wet colors are touching each other. And in this project, it's okay.